Welcome to the Morning Update. We want to wish a happy birthday to our very own Finn DeSisto. If you see them in the hallway, make sure to serenade them. I promise they'll enjoy it. Enjoy this week's Morning Update episode. Take
Attention,
it away.
Attention, juniors. This is just a reminder for those who previously registered. There will be a school day SAT administration on Wednesday, March 2nd. That's the week we return from break. There are study guides available for pickup in the school counseling office. Students should arrive between 7:20 to 7:35 a.m. on the morning of the exam and go to the school counseling office to obtain your test room location. More details about your schedule for the day will be coming soon. You should do some SAT prep over break so you are ready to do your very best. Please see Mrs. DeLafano if you have any questions. That's all for me. Take it away.
Counselors are available 24/7. The need to talk to a counselor does not end when school closes. Things happen at night, on weekends, and during holidays and vacations. With Project Safety Net, the 24/7 telephone support and resource helpline, youth, parents, guardians, and caring adults can talk anonymously with a local counselor at any time, day or night, by calling 978-771-4619. Help is out there. If you're in need, give it a try.
Oh, to see without my eyes, the first time that you kissed me. By the time I cried, I built your walls around me. White noise, what an awful sound. Fumbling by Rogue River, feel my feet above the ground. Hand of God, deliver me. Oh, 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 is me.
Seniors, this is a reminder that the Masconomet Regional Scholarship Foundation application is currently open. The link was emailed on January 3rd to all Masco senior accounts. You must complete the survey by Friday, February 18th to be eligible for all the scholarships available. Don't forget!
Hello. Why do we always tell actors to break a leg?
I don't know. Why?
Because every play has a cast.
Very good.
Originally listed in the program of studies as Women's History, this semester-long class was recently reinvented as Gender Studies. This class is a branch of sociology where students learn about how gender norms are created and maintained, how identity and perceptions of gender identity influence the way people behave and interact, and more.
This class has been running for multiple years, but it is interesting every year because of the unique perspectives and the personal stories students bring to class.
I love that the class is different every time I teach it. I love that it's really a different conversation happening with the different groups of kids. There's so many different perspectives that come to the class. It's important to have a safe and sort of open environment to share, and once we establish that, I feel like the conversation can get really good.
And highly valued characteristic of gender studies is its safe and welcoming environment.
It's a very like safe, fun environment. It's a good group of people, and I feel like we're going to get closer towards as the class like progresses.
Since students do not spend too much time doing written work, they can engage in deep discussions in class.
I'd say the workload for this class is pretty light, which makes it easier for like there to be class discussions.
The discussions focus on student opinions and thoughts, as well as them sharing information about current events and how gender plays a role in their lives.
It's really about students sharing their opinion. I try to do a lot of sitting in a circle and discussing instead of, you know, bookwork or looking at the board.
At a glance, gender studies is a history-based class where students reflect on how gender roles have formed, changed, and are present today. The class relies on participation to enter deep conversations and create an open and welcoming environment. If you enjoy discussing and formulating opinions on history and current events, gender studies is a class for you.
The Rocketry Club's first year back since the pandemic has been filled with fun and new members.
I'd recently moved here, so it was a way of making friends and meeting new people.
The members all share an interest in rockets, some from when they were younger, like Dorian Floristal. He had been interested in rockets when he was younger, but stopped building them. The club has provided him a chance to rekindle that hobby.
I haven't really built them in a while, so just knowing that I could do this again here at Masco Rocket Club, it was really good.
While many people enjoy watching rocket launches, it can be difficult to find a group who is passionate about rockets and willing to build and launch them themselves.
It's really hard to find people that have the same interest in you when it comes to rocketry. And also, it's hard to bring a group together of kids and build rockets with them. So having a place that you can actually come and do it, like pretty much for free after school, is a great place for people to come and just show their interest and meet new people.
During their first meeting, they went outside and launched rockets, making an unforgettable memory for the members.
I think the first day of Rocket Club was very interesting to me because we launched a lot of really cool rockets that day, and it like started off our, I guess, journey through the club. And now that like I've launched rockets before myself, I have fond memories looking back on it, and it's really just really cool.
The task of learning how to build and launch rockets can seem daunting at first, but the club officers took the time to teach everyone how to do it properly.
People out there are interested in joining this club. We're always looking for new members, and it's always a fun time here.
The environment is very relaxed and laid back, and anyone who wants to join is more than welcome to do so.
I really recommend joining, even if you're not into rockets, because we just have fun. It's not like work and notes and everything. It's just we have fun, we hang out as a community, and just learn a little bit about rocketry.
Hey guys, and welcome back to the last sports update before February break. Starting off with gymnastics, they just had their senior night on February 6th and won in their last meet. Girls hockey also just had their senior night, and go check out those scores of their game on maxpreps.com. Last night, boys hockey played Winthrop at 5, and go check out those scores too on maxpreps.com. Masco girls and boys basketball is doing very well, and make sure you go and support your fellow Masco teammates. Masco Swim and Dive also just finished up their season winning states, which was huge, so make sure you go check out all those pictures as well.
Well, that's all from us this week. Hope you enjoyed all of the announcements, and I hope you have a wonderful break. See ya!